If you're thinking about purchasing a home here in the Monterey, California area, stay tuned as I will be going over housing prices, costs associated with purchasing, a timeline, and steps for purchasing here in Monterey County. Toby Fernie, aka the Teacher Realtor here with Caldwell Banker Realty. I've been a realtor here in the Monterey, California area for years and helped over 20 sets of buyers purchase a home in 2021's competitive real estate market. As I'm sure you're tired of hearing by now, this real estate market has been one of the toughest in a long time for buyers. Many homes are receiving multiple offers within the first week of being on the market, often over asking price and with contingencies removed. In order to be competitive in today's market, you need to have a plan and work with an experienced realtor who can help you navigate this process. Step one, financing. Let's start off by discussing the most important part of any real estate process, financing. If you're going to be purchasing your home with a loan, getting pre-approved for a mortgage is critical to starting the process. Looking for houses without a pre-approval is like shopping for a car without a driver's license. You can do it, but you may need to steal that car. That letter and your proof of funds are key for placing an offer on a house. Getting pre-approved can be done in a day or two if you're in a rush, but it's best to take your time and get all of your ducks in a row before you start looking for homes. From this, you'll be able to find out what you can afford and what your monthly payments will be, and this will help you determine and narrow down what neighborhoods to start your search in. If you need any advice on my preferred local lenders, as that really helps when you're putting in an offer in this area, feel free to give me a call or send me an email. Price ranges per zip code here in Monterey County. This is going to be a quick breakdown of prices depending on the zip code at the end of 2021. If you're looking at this video at a later date, keep in mind that home prices have gone up an average of 8 to 10% a year here in Monterey County since 2010 and went up almost 25% last year. This is going to be a very brief overview, and my channel does have plenty of videos that talks about more accurate pricing for each of these different zip codes that I'm going to be talking about. If you are looking to purchase something in the 500,000s, you're likely going to need to start looking for condos or in areas such as King City, Gonzales, or certain zip codes in Salinas. Moving into the 600 and 700,000s, you'll be able to start finding some homes in that price range in certain parts of Seaside. If you are looking in the 700,000s and 800,000s, you'll be able to find some homes in that price range in Marina. In the $800,000 to $1 million price range is where you're going to be able to find houses in Monterey proper, which is a city in Monterey County. In December 2021, the median sales price in Monterey proper is above $1.2 million. By and large, homes in Pacific Grove and Carmel Valley are going to be north of $1 million. If your budget is above $1,500,000, you'll be able to find some homes in Carmel, and the majority of homes in Pebble Beach are going to be at least $2 million. Please keep in mind that each of these zip codes is going to have a range of different houses and prices depending on the neighborhood, the square footage, and the quality of the home. Step number two, looking at houses. This is the fun part. Some advice to you if you're a first-time home buyer looking in the Monterey area, especially if you are from other parts of the country. Monterey is a difficult place when it comes to real estate in terms of having your cake and eating it too. I sometimes meet buyers looking for the perfect house being sold for a song. If you find that house, please let me know because I'll buy it. The perfect home in today's market is the 80-10-10 rule. This means that you like 80% of the house, 10% of the house isn't ideal, but you can live with it, and 10% of the house you're planning to change over time. Another piece of advice is that you're going to want to see houses the first week that they come on the market, or you may want to look for that diamond in the rough that other buyers have overlooked that has been on the market for a few months. This is going to be your best chance to negotiate, as likely the home is overpriced. Step number three, put in an offer. Once you've found the house that you like, working with your realtor, you're going to submit an offer through the California Residential Purchase Agreement. There will be a new residential purchase agreement as of January 2022, but the majority of these timelines are going to stay around the same. Once your offer is accepted, you're going to want to have your realtor schedule inspections with local and trusted inspectors. Unless specified otherwise in the contract or you remove your physical inspection contingency with your offer, you will typically have 17 days to get your inspections done. I typically recommend getting a general home inspection and a termite inspection at a minimum. From there and from those inspections, you can decide if you want to bring in a specialist such as a roofer or a plumber or an electrician based on what was found in those initial inspections. After those inspections is when you can renegotiate with the seller. You can request a credit, a repair, or a reduction in price based on those findings. Steps 4 and 5, appraisal and finalized loan. These steps are only done if you're purchasing a home with a mortgage and they will be scheduled and completed by your lender. It's pretty typical here in Monterey County for those to take around 21 to 25 days to do those two steps. Someone from the bank is going to have to come out and do an appraisal and they're going to need to check to see if they agree that the value of the home is what you're in contract for. If the home appraises at or above the value that you're in contract for, you're golden. If the home appraises for under that value, there are options that are available to you. If that happens, you can cross the bridge at the time and then you're going to want to check in with your realtor and your lender to see what options are available to you. A pre-approval is not the same as a final loan approval, and you can be denied your final loan approval, especially if you make any significant changes to your finances. This means do not quit your job, do not open a new credit card, do not cancel any credit cards, don't start a charity, do not buy a boat, do not buy a brand new car, whether near or far, as you may end up only being able to afford to live in that car. Basically, just don't do anything. Sit at home, do your paperwork, pack, and wait, and everything will turn out fine. So an overall timeline for this process, 30 days is pretty typical if you're purchasing a home with a mortgage here in Monterey County. It's important that you check in with your realtor and your lender to see what sort of timeline closings are going these days for your lender, as there have often been delays in appraisals as of late. Costs associated with buying a home. Okay, so this is an important thing to know. What are the costs associated with purchasing a home? One big real estate myth is that you need to put 20% down when you're purchasing a home. You don't. You can buy a home with as little as 3.5% down if you're using an FHA loan, and as little as 5% down if you're moving forward with a conventional loan. If you're a veteran using a VA loan, you can even put down 0% when purchasing a home. Having 10 to 20% for your down payment does look favorable when it comes to a seller reviewing offers, but you can purchase with less than those down. Let's use the example of an $800,000 home. 3.5% to 20% is quite a range there for your down payment on an $800,000 home. 3.5% of $800,000 would be $28,000, and 20% of that $800,000 home would be $160,000. On the good news front, most costs associated with purchasing a home and selling a home here in Monterey County are seller costs. Other costs that you'll have to front as a buyer include 50% of the escrow and title fees. And if you're purchasing a home with a mortgage, around 1% of the purchase price will be the cost to work with that lender. Your escrow fees will be around $3,000 to $4,000 as a buyer, just as a general estimate. And if we're using that $800,000 example, your cost to work with a lender will be around $8,000. These are very general estimates, so you can get a better idea after speaking with your lender and the title company on what those costs will actually be. The seller does pay both the buyer and the seller real estate fees out of their proceeds from selling the home. So while a buyer's agent realtor is not working for free, it's not something that you will be charged at the closing table as a buyer. So essentially, you get an advocate to navigate this complicated process at no charge to you. So again, if you're looking to purchase that home in Monterey County, feel free to give me a call. Whether you're a local looking to purchase a home or relocating to the Monterey area, I am passionate about helping you find the right home. Feel free to give me a call or send me an email at toby.ferney@gmail.com to get the process started. If you got any useful information out of this video, smash the like and subscribe buttons. Stay tuned for future content all about real estate and living here in Monterey, California.